What's up, man?
Dude, there are so many bags on your bike.
Are you embarrassed?
There
How are you?
Bags than other things.
What is this moto, coffee moto?
So we should go here, one ride.
Yeah, where is it? Oh.
Hudson County.
So guys, this is Raj, my biker friend.
Hello.
My only biker friend actually. I need to find some cool bikers.
You won't. The coolest one. I'm like Kelvin.
So I want to do a video of your bike.
Yeah, that's
maybe we'll find a...
I put new restrictors on my muffler, so
okay.
That sounds a little bit more smooth.
Okay. So should we leave or you want to chat here?
Yeah, let's go.
We'll talk somewhere on the way.
Yeah.
With
so
the...
I'm going directly to...
You know where it is, no?
Yeah. What is it called? The little market.
The market. Just get it on your map now, you may overshoot. So guys, Raj and I are just going for a bike ride, Sunday bike ride, and it was just impromptu decision. Raj was free and he called me, and Sunday I'm free, so we said let's
nine,
go.
The 9 West Market.
9 W Market.
Yeah.
But so yeah, it's a Sunday ride with Raj. His bike was in the garage for some time. I want to talk about his bike today, the Triumph Bonneville. He's had it for 13 years. He bought it in 2007, I guess. So we are going to hit the road. I may not vlog much on the road, but I will talk to you when we reach our coffee adda. Okay, we are rolling. So just a coffee ride today, guys, because I have to get back to the family. But yes, it's going to be fun. Anything with the bikes is fun. Okay, so we're just on the way passing the George Washington Bridge. And Raj is in front of me. There are a lot of other bikers on the road. It's a good day to ride today, guys. Nice sunny. I've worn a riding shirt. Raj too is wearing a light shirt because we're not going very far. Just a coffee joint. So at the coffee shop, I'm going to talk to Raj about his bike and his experience with the Triumph Bonneville. We'll talk to him at the coffee shop. Lot of cyclists on the road, as always on Sunday. You got to be very careful with the cyclists. Make sure you don't bang any of them, you'll lose your license. This is the Brownstone Pancake Factory. Big crowd here because it's open now after COVID. Sorry Raj, I'm just vlogging. I'm a YouTube star, no? So see this guy. Then they wonder why we bang into them. After the signal changes, he's crossing.
I was lost in the woods, on the dust, and the fairies found me. And they led the way. They clear the way to my home. All the hurt, all the pain under the skin, I had fainted. And they carried me.
So we are here at our hangout. There are a lot of cyclists and bikes here. We got a Ducati Victory. We got a Bolt. Harley Davidson, I think, and then another Harley, and of course Raj is here with his short hair. So the coffee shop is open, but only one per person, one at a time is allowed. So we're gonna wait for our coffee and talk to Raj also. Yeah, it's nice here. It's a little gloomy. It's going to rain soon, I don't think, for the next couple of hours.
What, your back is already hurting?
Yeah. Are you liking the helmet? Good.
Really like it.
I like this helmet, F70.
Honestly, I think, I tried the Shoei.
Yeah.
I find this to be better than the
other. Okay.
They clear the way to my heart. They into love with another. So we're at the cafe here. All the bikes are lined up. That's my bike. This is Raj's bike. Raj is just gonna get us some coffee, so I'm hiding under the tree here for better shade. Thanks, Raj. What are you having?
Cortado.
Cortado. What is that? A coffee, right?
A nice cookie.
Okay. I'm having some lemon peel ginger root. I don't know if there's a lot of sugar in these things. Yeah?
It's all sweet.
Okay. We're just gonna admire the bikes and then log off. This is a Triumph Bonneville 58.
So that's 2013.
What about this, Raj? This is a Yamaha.
Yeah, the guy said he built this himself. 1100cc 1995 engine with an 82 frame. And you can see he's done a monoshock conversion.
I don't think the sound will catch it, but really cool, yeah.
I love these kind
of 1100cc.
I love these kind of custom
builds. Yeah.
You can see he's done the.
It's a total custom build bike.
Yamaha R1.
Yeah. So front is a Yamaha R1 and he's chopped the bike up, so nice seat. Very cool, yeah. This is a Moto Guzzi here. What's this, a V7?
Not my favorite.
No?
The complete stranger.
Hey Raj.
Hey Ryan.
How's it going?
Good.
So we tried to find a bit of a silent parking spot here. There was too much noise in the cafe.
Very beautiful trail, as you can see. Yeah. This is the Tallman Mountain State Park.
Yeah. Actually, ahead you can take a right and you get the whole trail. I've done a video there. Yeah, we went there too. So Raj is here with his Triumph Bonneville. This is 800, right? CC?
This is an 865. An 07 model, as you can see over here. This is a 07 model, as you can see.
Okay, 07, yeah.
So
you bought this in which part of the US?
I actually bought this in New York.
New York,
yeah,
okay.
So back then, there was a Triumph Ducati dealership in Manhattan.
Right.
I think they've unfortunately gone out of business.
But right.
I bought this bike. Someone had actually traded it in, and it had only 500 miles on it.
Oh, okay. I didn't know it was pre-owned, so it had 500 miles.
Yeah, so it had 500 miles on it. I saw it parked outside, and I loved the color.
Yeah, yeah.
So this was a very limited color that Bonneville came out with.
Right.
That's why I love
yeah,
it.
Yeah, it's a great color.
Thank you.
And it's kind of sober, but yet not too sober.
Yeah, so that's why I bought it.
Yeah. And you paid how much, Raj, when you bought this?
I think when I bought it, it was, so brand new was about 10,000. I bought this for maybe between 7,500 and 8,000.
7,500 to 8. So now they're going up for about 12, right?
Yeah, so I think more or less the prices are still the same.
Right.
Surprisingly enough.
They hold their value.
Yeah, they hold their value, but now they have the special editions and all, which are a little bit more. So if you deck out a Bonneville, like in
with all the fittings,
accessories, it's about roughly 20,000. Yeah.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Oh wow.
But you can get it as low as 12,000.
So 12 is the starting.
12 is your starting.
Yeah. So you've done a lot of changes recently. A summary of some of them.
Yeah. So I actually over the years I've done a lot of changes. So this was as an 07. This was, I think. The second last year before they switched to an EFI.
Right.
So this has carburetors.
Okay.
So this is modded with a stage one Dynojet.
Right.
I have the cam covers from a Thruxton.
Okay.
You can see that. So the front forks were actually switched out for progressives.
Mm-hmm.
And this has a custom machined instrument gauge.
Okay.
Stain-tuned exhausts.
Stain-tuned exhausts, okay. So you changed these recently or?
No, these came when I bought the bike. So these are actually handmade in Australia.
Yeah, I saw that, made in Australia. Cool, are these expensive?
It's about $1,400.
Wow.
Yeah, they're pretty expensive because it's
just for slip-ons?
Well, it's actually the whole thing.
Oh, okay.
That's why they're expensive.
So it's like a stage one in a Harley.
Exactly.
So 1400 is not that bad actually.
And I just recently put on some restrictors on it.
Okay.
To kind of bring it down.
So has the bike ridden, given you any trouble in these 13 years or?
You know, there
mostly?
Were some small issues. Like, so what I have done is I kind of have done some modifications to make it like better for me. So I've changed the CDI system.
Hmm.
It's got Nology ignition coils.
Nology ignition coils, CDI system.
It's got the Iridium spark plugs.
Okay.
And, you know, the Nology leads to the plugs.
Right.
So I made some changes to the electrical system.
Uh-huh.
And I think that really kind of increased the performance a little bit. The CDI, which is a ProCom, is actually very unique because you can actually program it. So
right.
It's kind of like a carbureted bike, which is a... like an EFI, because I can put in my own maps.
Right.
So I can rejet the bike and reprogram the CDI to match the jetting.
Oh, okay.
So that I can actually get proper sort of performance.
Yeah, so that's great, Raj. And you're not tempted to sell it or upgrade to a new model?
You know, just last week I was at the dealership and the guy was tempting me to trade it in. And I'll be honest that for a moment I was tempted, but you know, I love the fact that I've made changes to this bike and it's kind of my own now. And
you probably won't get much because of the age, so you rather just keep it.
I mean, so you know, once you've kind of, you know, you make your bike your own and then it's hard to sell it anyways. And I won't get a good price, so it doesn't really make sense. If anything, I might get another bike.
Right.
For now, this is staying.
Yeah, this seems great, and we're gonna ride some more in July and August.
Yeah.
So thanks, Raj. We're going to hit the road back home.
Pleasure.
We just did a short coffee ride and, you know, just want to make sure we get back home for lunch. So Raj is signing out now. Thanks for joining, Raj.
Thanks for having me.
And hope you guys like the bike. Please like and comment about the Triumph. We got both bikes here and we're heading back home.
I guess you can see now that Triumph is also very popular in India.
Yeah. They're selling the Tiger. The Tiger sells a lot.
So when I bought this, Triumph was still very niche,
I
guess. And now they're much more mainstream. But that's good. I think it's a great brand.
Yeah, so all the Triumph fans who watch this video, please comment and like and give us some support for Raj. Keep far from these underhanded men. All right, back on the GoPro and just heading out. Raj, I'll follow you.
Okay.
Yeah. So, hope you guys enjoyed Raj's talk about his bike. Whoever are the bike fans will appreciate it. All right, let's roll. Guys, just back home and done with the ride. Bike is waiting there, parked. All well. So, please like, share, subscribe. Hope you enjoyed this Sunday vlog. Take care, guys. Bye.